So good day, everyone, and welcome to our May Incubating Leadership Conversation. These conversations are organized by the Leadership Forum Community, which is a nonprofit 501c3 focused on expanding conscious leadership. You can learn more about the organization or find ways to get involved by visiting our website at leadershipforumcommunity.org or inquiring within the chat and somebody will get back to you. We like to start in the beginning of our leadership forum, of our incubating leadership conversations, to just have a brief moment, which we call our diversity moment. And this is a moment as the leadership forum is expanding and we recognize that we are, international organization, we like to take a moment to take time and reflect on our differences and how that may bring us together in our leadership journey. For this ILC, there's been a lot of events recently, and I would just like to take a brief moment of silence, although I wish, we could be in a position to do more, but a brief moment of silence to just remember and pray for the victims across the country, recently in Buffalo, and even more recently for the younger ones in Texas. So with that, we'll just take a brief moment of silence to reflect and in remembrance. Thank you all for taking time to reflect and remember those that have may experience hardship across the country as things are happening all around. So with that, I'd like to just do a brief introduction. My name is Matthew. I'm an officer within the community, and I'm pleased to present our topic of discussion today, Dreaming and Doing, presented by Poey and Linden. Poey and Linden will use the polarity tools to drive a deeper conversation into dreaming and doing, which is, this serves as our ILC kickoff to our upcoming annual summit, The Power of Dreams, which will take place next month. So we'll have more information at the end, but definitely feel free to reach out during the conversation if you'd like to get more information or if you'd like to register. We'll have links to share within chat as we get towards the end of the presentation, but I don't want to steal too much of Poey's and Linden's thunder as they bring us in into sharing about dreaming and doing. So welcome, Poey and Linden, and thank you so much for sharing today. I'm passing it over to you all.
Thank you, Matthew, and thank you, the Leadership Forum community. And Matthew, thank you for giving us this diversity moment at the beginning of our ILC. I feel that the Leadership Forum community has always been a platform for us to address the most challenging topics of our times. And I know one of our most pressing leadership challenges of today is understanding racism and really appreciating the importance of mental health and how all of this exists and impacts our organizations, our communities, and our society. So thank you, Matthew, for giving us the space to process these recent events that are happening. And I think by all of us gathering today here, it's a reminder that we have the power to stand together and create positive change for our world. And the very first step to do that is to believe that we are all leaders, leaders who have the capacity and ability to lead with love. So thank you, Goth, for highlighting that, and Joel for highlighting that. And it doesn't matter if leadership is in a job title or a position title or not. We must invest time in advancing our own conscious leadership, and which is the mission of the Leadership Forum community. So we can all show up as leaders that we want to be known for in this world and contribute to our communities and our society in a positive way, and impact others in a positive way at the same time. So truly honored to be here with Linden to talk about today's topic, dreaming and doing. And it's, reflecting back on the past 2 years, throughout 2020 and 2021, and even the beginning of this year, the Leadership Forum community, especially through these conversations and even last year's summits, we explored how leaders at all levels will need to be conscious of how to repair what has been lost and look for how to rebuild the future. in a way that is even more human, right? That's very productive for our society, for our communities, and for our organizations. And so we thought this year's summit, which as Matthew highlighted, will happen within a month. Hope that you can all join us on June 22nd and June 23rd. We will be exploring and activating the inherent power that we all have as human to dream. And we want to discover ways to not only help us dream, but to move into actions so that we can, again, contribute to creating a better future, a better tomorrow for all of us. And that's why we're here today with our ILC. We want today to be a prelude to our summit, to jumpstart our inherent ability to dream for a better future together, so that we can turn any challenges we face as individuals, or our family might be facing right now, our friends and neighbors may be facing right now, friends and neighbors from around the world, turn those challenges into possibilities that can really lead to a better future for all of us. So thank you for joining us today. Again, I'm honored to be here with Lyndon Rago. Lyndon's gonna take us through an interactive session and to help us think about the power of dreaming and doing and leveraging the polarity management framework that many of us have learned last year during our summit. And by the end of today, we really hope that we give everybody an opportunity to reflect on an important goal or dream that we all have, and how it's critical that we must continue to dream about it and at the same time consider and engage in concrete actions that will help us achieve that dream. So Lyndon, I'm going to turn things over to you to maybe introduce yourself and to get us started.
Great. Thank you so much, Poi. And I noticed that we have one of our participants all the way from Mauritius, and I just wanted to do a shout out because I spent a couple of years in Mauritius and my profile picture on the screen was actually from Mauritius. So just want to call that out. But Matthew, as he led us off in today's session, really invoked something that is a source of great kind of pain in America, which is around gun violence. And many of us might find ourselves on one side of this issue or the other, right? And the polarities framework is a slightly different way of thinking about sometimes these intractable issues that we find ourselves in. And it's a fairly powerful tool. And so today we have an opportunity to explore this tool, but also apply it to this theme of the conference, which is about dreaming about possibility, but also putting them into practice. So I want to advance a couple of slides, I think, here to get to our kickoff slide. Yeah. So this one here is we often think about challenges in terms of problems. And a problem is something that has a right or wrong or best answer, right? There is a solution that exists. But in reality, a lot of the things that we face are actually polarities. These are things that can't be solved, but rather can be a paradox or something that has opposing sides, poles, if you will, that need to be balanced. And this polarity framework helps us think about these kinds of challenges in a fresh way. So we'll advance the slide here, and I'll do an illustration with the concept of breath. And this is a very simple way to understand the notion of polarities. So I'll invite you to join me here, and I'll count for you. But if you would breathe in for a count of four, so I'll count to 1, 2, 3, 4, and hold 1, 2, 3, 4, and exhale for 4, 2, 3, 4. And now I'm going to kind of double it up and ask you to do this each for 8, and I'll count out for you as well. So inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, hold 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and exhale 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's it, we'll pause there. So what you might have noticed in this zone of breathing is that as you breathe in, you, of course, had this influx of oxygen into your system. It felt good. But at some point, as you move towards even holding the breath, even on the count of four, you felt the need to exhale. And especially as we moved to the cycle of 8, where that was stretched out a little bit towards a greater extreme, you probably felt the desire to probably get to that exhale quicker. Or as you exhaled out, you probably hit a point closer to that 8-point mark where you said, well, I just need some fresh air, right? So in this case, we recognize breath as a certain kind of polarity. It's not just about breathing in It's not just about breathing out, but it's a certain kind of balance of those two sides. So if we advance the slide here, so it's very much about this notion of the both and, right? And we hear this expression, a lot of problems, challenges in the world, perhaps can be looked at from a different lens of rather than saying one is right or wrong, but how do we find the harmony, the synchronicity between the two sides? How do we find the zone of flow? How do we connect the dots across? How do we use co-creative approaches that don't seek to kind of negate one side or the other, but really use the balance of both those forces? So if you advance to the next slide here, we can kind of see that actually a lot of things that we might face in our organizations and our work represent these kinds of forces. You know, is it good to have centralization or decentralization? Actually, both are good, but there is a downside to both of these if they're overdone, right? Similarly, flexibility and stability, both good, and in excess, both bad. Cost and quality feel like trade-offs, but it's not one against the other. And so too, again, with our focus today about dreaming and doing, we need both of these sides, and it'll be an opportunity to explore how might we leverage the power of both of these forces to enhance our ability to be more effective, more productive, more fulfilled. So again, if we advance here. All right, so this is a simplified version of a polarity map, and it's got a number of things going on, but we'll work our way through this. And we're gonna invite you to join in as we do this and use the chat to help us figure out this map. What you'll see is this is essentially a 2x2. On the left side, there is dreaming. On the right side, there is doing. You'll see that there is an and in the middle. That's very central to this both and kind of concept. And both have two upper and lower quadrants. And so the upper quadrants represent the upside of this equation, and the lower quadrants represent the downside. And the downside is really about when something is overdone, where it starts to tip into things that are not so productive. So I'm gonna ask you, as you think about the dreaming, the left side of this map, you know, what's the upside of dreaming? And if you can think about, you know, what does that look like? The behaviors, the impact, the activities that you might engage when you're in a positive zone of dreaming or visioning or thinking about possibilities. Use the chat and help us fill out this map. We'll probably get a few things on this map here. So I see imagining new possibilities. That's there, get new ideas. It's a good thing that Poi is a fast typer here. These things move quickly, getting new ideas, another one. What else is an upside of dreaming? Inspiration, great. No constraints, everything's possible, you know, when you're dreaming, yeah. Create next generation impact, really going beyond where you are right now. Great, thank you. Creative movement from the old, yeah, it's really about this innovation, fresh ideas. It's fun and openness. Great. So free-flowing thinking, giving hope. So we might pause there. So we've gotten quite a few up there and you get the idea, right? There's a lot of good, if you will, towards dreaming. Let's move to the side, to the right side. What does the positive elements of doing look like? So if you're in the zone of doing, what does that look like? What do you see? Once again, type in the chat and we'll get these on the map there. Creating an impact, progress, growth and change, yeah. Making things happen, right? Executing a plan, accomplishment, satisfaction, learning, solving problems, tangible results, one little thing adding up to it, it's a bigger thing, you know, activity, you've got impact, great. So again, once again, we've got a number of things up here to give us a sense of, yeah, there's a lot of upside to doing, right? Let's now pivot to the bottom left-hand side of dreaming. So what's the downside of just dreaming? Dream is without taking action, right? What does that look like when we're just kind of, if we're trapped in endless dreaming or just doing that? So we're in the bottom left-hand side. Once again, we'll type into the chat. So no action. So again, similar, there it's a lot of thinking, becoming numb to reality, so disconnected, too much fluff, we're not engaged, we're frozen as to how to start. See a word flighty out there, stalling, paralysis, ineffectuality, impractical. Great. So once again, we can see that there is a downside when we're just kind of caught in dreaming, right, to an excess. How about we go over to the right lower quadrant? What does it look like when we are just kind of trapped in just endless doing, right? What does that look like? Again, we'll use the chat here. We're just in this loop of doing. Just we're caught in busyness, don't have time to think. We're in hamster wheel, right? That repetition, not enough creativity, new ideas, limited by the to-do list, right? Yeah. Mindless distraction, expenditure of energy. Good. Yeah. Maybe miss out in relationships. Yeah. We're just busy, just doing. It's tiring. You can feel really exhausted. So once again, maybe a final comment in there, no pausing, reflection, improvement, right? It's very clear that what we see is that there is a downside to just being caught in this loop of doing, right? So what we really want to do is really think about how do we shift out of this? And the idea of polarity thinking is that it's not one against the other. What do we need to do to stay in balance between the two top quadrants, right? To get the best of dreaming and get the best of doing. So if we think about the outside part of this map here, and it says positive actions. So if we want to kind of remind ourselves of the things we might need to do to stay in the upper zone of dreaming, what might we need to do? Once again, use the chat. What are some reminders we can give ourselves to say, well, here are some practices and things we might do to make sure that we're making enough time for dreaming, whatever that dreaming is about, whether it's work or family. So take a deep breath, pen down and activate the dreams. Yeah, put it down on paper, make it more tangible. Journal every day. Once again, about the capture of kind of turning those dreams into something a little bit more concrete. Mindfulness. Great. Draw it. Good. Let me go over now to the right side, right? So if we are in the zone of reminding ourselves to focus on action and doing, what are some things we could be reminding ourselves to kind of put into motion? Keep at, create a plan, project plan, right? To-do list, to get that to the essentials, get a little bit more concrete about how do you turn those dreams to action. Accountability partner, great, yeah. Good. And match our actions with our values, right? Hold those intentions, but make sure that we are focused on action. Let me go then to the bottom left here. So if we think about when we are moving towards just doing too much dreaming or being caught there, what are some warning signs? So, and this is really important because when we see warning signs, it's a trigger or a reminder to actually pivot to the other side of this equation. So what are warning signs that you might see if you're just doing an excessive dreaming? So we're in the bottom left hand on the outer side here. So if you're just dreaming, but not doing a whole lot, and this dreaming, of course, yes. What are those signs in terms of what you might see, what you might feel, ignoring reality, being disconnected from what's going on? Yeah. Procrastination. Good. Yeah. You know, little tangible growth and change, frustration of not getting things done. Good. frozen. Good. So you got a clear sense that there is a level of inertia when we are really caught in endless kind of dreaming, if you will. And let's go over then to the other side again, this final kind of area. What's a warning sign of that we might see in terms of when we're just caught in endless doing or kind of doing loop without enough dreaming? Burnout, great. Tiredness, lack of energy. Fixed plans are not relevant. Fatigue, yeah. Unmotivated, great. Diminishing returns, great. Constant sprints, great. So we might just pause there, stagnation, yeah. So we've really got this idea, right? That there are things that kind of tell us that when we've gone too far on one side or the other, that we really need to recalibrate. And it's the positive actions, right, on the other side that then tell us what are the things that we might need to up to really bring this back into a certain kind of virtuous space. So I wanted to maybe give you another dip in this and just talk about my own work, because soon we're going to ask you to complete your own map. And thinking that just doing an illustration one more time relative to my own kind of challenges might create some clarity for you. So, and you'll see a certain kind of repetition of a lot of things that are on this map. So I run an effort called Cometa, and this is something that that is focused on community development, bringing people together to create better social outcomes locally. And it's a lot of work that is about creating a new venture, trying to address social impact in ways that are challenging. And so when I am on the positive side of dreaming, I'm kind of soaking up new ideas by reading, looking for ideas. I have conversations, great conversations with people that are inspiring, that offer new inputs. You know, I'm visiting organizations that are doing work functions. I'm doing some meditation that helps me get centered and process things. Similarly too, on the right side, if I'm doing effectively, then I might be writing and mapping and planning some of the things that you all have said. I'm also prototyping. I've got some ideas. I work to put them in motion, even in a small kind of way that helps me gain clarity as to whether those things are working or not. And then I'm also being disciplined about capturing outcomes and reporting, but that helps me kind of harvest the learning. If I go over to the bottom left, again, some of the things that you've talked about, if I'm just caught in dreaming, which I can kind of very easily do, that I could be spending a lot of time just soaking information, there's an endless amount of things to read and scroll through online. I have the sense of paralysis. I'm caught in too much information, but I'm not necessarily clear on what to do. And I might get demotivated as well. And so if I move then to the right side of just not doing or just doing too much, it's I don't have enough time to process. You know, I'm not distilling the learning because I'm busy doing and I'm not figuring out how to make things better. So results tend to be discouraging after a while. And it's not maybe making the best use of time and resources, right? So what might I need to remind myself to do if we go to the next slide and we move to that outer area? Right. So again, some of what you kind of really raised for us, I need to be on the outer left, be intentional about what my goals are. So I could be focused as I'm kind of doing my dreaming. You know, I kind of manage the time that I'm spending online because there's just endless things to look at and read. I really need to connect with people because that provides me with a lot of good input. I need to really make time for the downtime for meditation, reflection, because that helps me get clear about those intentionalities. If I go over to the right again, really I need to get better at planning, getting it down on paper, as some of you have said before. I need to be mindful of running experiments, even if I haven't got it all figured out. I did an event yesterday for community change agents. And a lot of great information, but it takes a lot of discipline to harvest that information, capture it, document it, put it out there, and that really helps the learning. So the warning signs on the left again is that I might see again, if I'm just doing too much dreaming, there's a lack of progress, no direct actionable learning, things that you've mentioned. And on the right side, get to that place of boredom because, hey, I'm not really switching it up, I'm not learning, results start to drop. I really don't have a lot of evidence because I haven't really documented the impact of what I'm doing, right? So I think hopefully we're all kind of clear now about what this map is. And we're going to invite you now to actually take some time and complete your own map. So there are a couple of ways to do that. I think Poi's got a link for you that she'll put in the chat. If you have access to a printer and it's easy for you, you can just kind of print out this form and fill it out. Or if you'd like, you can, all you need is a blank sheet of paper and something like that, just a 2x2, right? And you can complete your own map. So if that's easy to do, you can do it on an electronic document or a sheet of paper, or you could print out the form from Poi. But we've got like about, not a lot of time here because we want to get you into some groups where you can share, but would like you to take maybe about 5 to 7 minutes just to put some things down relative to your own dreaming and doing map. And this can be anything that you believe is important in your life. So it could be related to work, you know, your professional areas. Maybe it's related to your family and what you might need to do to kind of enhance family and personal life. Maybe it's about a summer vacation and maybe you're thinking about some things and there are things you might need to do to get much more clear about the dreaming or the doing side of things. Maybe it's about your spiritual practice. It could be about any number of things. So whatever is meaningful for you, use this as an opportunity really to do some processing of how you're doing with this dreaming and doing balance. So hopefully that's clear. We're going to be quiet for about, you know, 5 minutes, give you time to complete your map, and then we'll put people in breakout groups where you'll get to share it with a couple of other people and maybe get some additional insights and input. Okay, so I'm going to ask Matthew to put us in breakout rooms and groups of three, and hopefully you'll have one or two other people there with you to share your map. And, you know, each person, we're going to give you about 15 minutes, so each person will have about 5 minutes chance to share your map and talk about what's going on, and maybe get a little bit of input from other people. Maybe if you're listening in, you can ask some questions, offer some input as you listen to the person, or just simply be supportive. So roughly about 5 minutes each. And if you haven't finished your map just yet, maybe as you're in the session, you'll get some ideas of things that you can add. So I hope you enjoy your group conversations as we move into breakouts. We'll come back 10 to the hour and then have a little time for wrap up here.
Welcome back everyone from the breakout room. So I'm just really curious if anybody wants to, it's all great to see you coming back with smiles and energy. I'm really curious about what was discussed in your room. If anybody wants to jump in and share a highlight of your discussion with the whole group, that would be great because platform like this allow us to learn together and also learn from each other. So curious if anybody wants to just jump in and share a little bit of what you talked about.
I'm happy to jump in. So Lyndon, thank you. I love this model. I'm a big fan of models and frameworks and matrices. So and I thought this was great. I always say you can't think outside the box until you have something inside the box. So this helps you take some of your ideas and put them in a framework that you could see possibilities, and reminded me of the Covey time management matrix, balancing urgency and important, turning ideas into actions and actions into results. So for me, it really helped to frame a lot of things. So and I had a great conversation with Garth and Derek, who I'd not met before. So I'll leave it at that. But I love the model. It just triggered a lot of different thoughts. And we all spend a lot of time doing, but not necessarily turning dreams into actions. Or we have too many dreams that we get paralyzed by indecision and we don't do anything about it. So I think this helps us to focus and to think more clearly. So those are some of my initial thoughts.
Thank you, Todd. And just to build on that, because Matthew, you point out something really important too, is that sometimes once we are in action, like we may already turn our dreams into reality, but we realize that it's a journey. It doesn't just stop right there. So we got to go back to dreaming and doing and dreaming and doing to make sure that we're, you know, continue to evolve and create things that meet the needs of this world, right? So Matthew, I just want to highlight what you share with us because it goes really nicely with what Todd is sharing. Anybody else?
You know, I'll jump in. you know, applying this personally to me, but also thinking about how it impacts the organization, you know, the leadership roles that I have. You know, I renamed Dreaming and Doing, you know, we probably could have chosen any polarity, but it was around aspiration and execution. And a friend from this community years ago said, you know, how does our execution match our aspiration? So how does our execution match our aspiration? And I've been processing that actually over years. And this map really helped me think about what's the personal part that I have in that as a leader, and how does that impact others that I work with across the organization? And so it was really fascinating how, you know, an area that I always need to work on is kind of that project management execution space, and how actually having the project plan, having the clarity that comes along with that, not only helps me deliver the impact that if I'm trying to drive something or the team is trying to drive something, but it really helps us get that impact clear. And it helps everyone else on the journey, you know their part and know the ways that they can plug in. So this turned into like a really helpful tool for me personally and how I can execute within a broader organization. And we had great conversation too across our team. It was wonderful to connect with Eileen and Anne and hear everyone's dreaming and doing aspirations.
Thank you, Joel. That's really great. You just reminded us how that self-awareness is really important, right? Doing this type of reflection, but at the same time, not to feel that we're alone in this, right? The fact that we have a community like this, the fact that we activate our thoughts around doing and dreaming, that's where we can pull other people in to help us, to support us on this journey. And it's just really great. So I appreciate that. That's what re-triggered in me as you were talking. Any other final thoughts, Steve?
Mm-hmm. I want to just thank, I'm not going to get into the details, but I want to thank my friend Bill Hunnix. Thank you, Bill. Thank you.
Thank you, Steve. Thank you, Bill.
Yes, we had a good conversation.
Good. Thank you for sharing that. All right. Well, I know we only have a couple more minutes, so we just want to, you know, thank everyone for being here. We want to remind all of you, we want to see you again. Again, you already witnessed and experienced the power of a platform like this. So we want all of you come back and bring people that you feel will benefit from conversations like this. And within the month, on June 22nd and June 23rd, we will be launching our summit. It's 2 half days from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. Eastern. So hopefully you could come join us, and we will be exploring the power of dreams. And again, going a little bit deeper even into what it means to continue to dream and to get into actions. And we'll have provocateurs, including Todd Churches, who is here with us today, helping us, telling us stories, ideas, and techniques that we can absolutely immediately apply, not only to help achieve our own dreams, but help each other achieve our dreams. So thank you so much for being here. And Matthew, I'm going to pass it back to you to wrap us up. Thank you, everyone.
Yeah, thanks, Poe, and thanks, Lyndon. This session is always great. And like you said, it's good for, you know, personal reflection and to kind of reevaluate where you're at and where you're going. So really appreciate you both for doing this and setting us up for next month. And again, if you enjoyed this session, feel free, and you're not on the email list or you want to be aware of what's coming up next, feel free to message me directly with your email, and we'll make sure that you are on our email distribution list. Again, we are not nonprofit, the Leadership Forum, so this is all brought to you off the labor of the community that we all, you know, see the value in this. So feel free to utilize the QR code on your left to give donations, or use the QR code on your right if you want to become a member. Excuse me. I also put the summit registration in the link in the chat box as well for all those that are not registered yet, because it will be a good one. As Poe mentioned, you see the impact that the Leadership Forum can have. So we look forward to seeing you all next month, and we thank you all for joining us today. And again, thank you to the speakers for their time. Enjoy the rest of your day, everyone.
Thanks, see y'all soon.
Bye.
Thank you, bye-bye, everyone.